Please tell me who you are so I can check our passengers list.
I am the 45th president of the United States.
Welcome aboard, Mr. President. Take a seat. Good afternoon. Please tell me who you are so I can check our passengers list.
Hi, I'm the smartest man in the world. And, I'm very important. This badge right here is for the smartest man in the world. I need to get to my badge right now.
Welcome aboard, smart man. Please take a seat. Good afternoon. Please tell me who you are so I can check our passengers list.
My name is Quadro. I'm a local camper.
Welcome aboard. Please take a seat. This is your pilot. We are cleared for takeoff. Please buckle your seatbelt and enjoy the ride. I'm sorry to report that we have a major malfunction. The plane is losing altitude and we will crash in just a few minutes. We need to parachute to safety. Follow me. I have more bad news. We only have 3 parachutes.
I am the president. My country needs me to build the wall.
I'm the smartest man in the world. I need to do something. So, you guys, let me know.
Well, there's only one chute left. You take it. I guess the pilot will go down with the ship.
Actually, there's 2 chutes left.
Really? How is that possible?
The smartest man in the world just jumped out with my backpack.
Skits. We're gonna see if we can find like special meaning from it, like one of the scout law points. So does anyone think they know which one it was? There's no right answer. Mr. Stouffer.
Look before you leap.
Yeah.
This one, just to add a little introspective, this one's a little more challenging. We're trying to try to focus in on a point of the scout law. So can you, of the 12 points, can anybody identify a point and then explain to us why?
I'd say brave, because the pilot was brave enough that he said he would go down with his ship.
That's good.
Lucas? Helpful, because the camper told the pilot that the last parachute was not actually, or was a parachute, and along with the other one.
Okay.
Yo, dog, halt! This looks like some poopy.
Okay, smell it, see if it smells like poopy.
Oh dear, that smells like poopy.
Touch it, see if it feels like poopy.
Oh my, that feels like poopy.
Now taste it, see if it tastes like poopy.
Oh, that tastes like poopy. It's poopy!
Oh, good thing we didn't step in that.
Does anybody have an idea about that one? Anybody?
Oh, I got one.
Mr. Vanosky.
Helpful. Because the one guy tasted the poopy.
And he noticed that there was poopy on the trail, so that they didn't step in it.
It's a poopy.
Jaredon.
Brave, because he was brave enough to taste the poopy.
That's a good point. Lucas Jenner.
Trustworthy, because he told him that it was poopy.
Mrs. Armsman.
Clean, because they walked around the poopy.
Yeah. Yay!
But I ate the poopy.
But
But he still ate it, though. Yeah.
Does anybody else have any?
He didn't track it in the house when he got home.
I've got one, I've got one, I've got one.
Mr. Cholsky.
He was cheerful because Hunter was so cheerfully helping out and helpful to touch, smell, and taste the poopy.
Yeah, that I did. Use the senses.
Scout is sensitive.
I don't think that's what happens when you eat food.
Recycle has a new meaning.
You have all been found guilty of spying. You will each be shot by firing squad as soon as the squad arrives. First prisoner, take your place. Ready. Aim.
Hurricane!
Ah!
Wait, there's no hurricane there.
Oh, darn. Next prisoner, take your place. Ready? Aim.
Tidal wave!
Oh. Ah!
Wait, there's no tidal wave there.
Bamboozled dead again.
Next prisoner, take your place. Ready? Aim!
Fire!
Fire! That's something I would do.
Does anybody have any ideas about that one?
That one would be helpful because he helps them.
Victor?
Somewhat brave because it showed proof of known suicide.
What? Yes. You mean?
Oh no, that was just because Neil's not intelligent.
What?
What did I do?
Does anybody else have any? Mr. Stouffer.
Thoughtful, because the second prisoner thought of some really good ideas.
Yeah.
That's not a scout law, though.
Once again. Yeah.
Mr. Stouffer's a renegade scout.
Yeah.
That's Mr. Stouffer's 13th law.
Yes.
He broke the bottle.
Ooh, oh no, I know where this is going already.
That was Michigan.
Oh, now. I hear nature calling. Gotta go.
Camp soup. Smells especially good today. Cookie won't mind if I try it. Boy, that's good. I can't wait for lunch.
Good soup.
Hey, Cookie.
Great soup.
Yeah,
very flavorful. What kind of soup is it?
I wasn't making soup.
Get scrubbed.
Does anybody have any ideas what that one was? Victor!
50, because you're reusing your sweat.
Yeah.
Oh.
Sure. It's not a good idea, but it, you did.
Lucas!
Careful, because they're happy to drink the right juices.
That's cool.
Oh,
Does anybody else have anything?
Did we say clean?
No, actually no one said
clean! Because he's just cleaning his socks.
Because they just, they were drinking sock soup.
What?
I seem to have caught a fish. Oh dear, I seem to have caught yet another fish. Oh boy, I caught a third fish.
How come you have been able to catch three fish in a row while we've been out here all since early evening? We haven't caught a single fish.
You're
supposed to be speaking in a foreign language.
You have to keep the worms warm.
Does anybody know what that one could possibly be? Lucas!
Helpful because he gave him the secret to the fishing.
Yeah, I didn't know that. I had to do that. Brett?
Brave because a young man put the worms in his mouth.
Does anybody else have any? Mr. Cholsky!
Thrifty, he used his resources.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He didn't waste no money on no cooler or anything.
Or box.
Well, actually, if you kept the one, never mind. Does anybody else have anything before we do the next one?
Yeah.
What if you just put one?
The 14th element of the law, which is consistent, because it's the same kid who tasted the poopy.
Nice! Very helpful. It's a BH.
What a coincidence!
Very low.
Or is it?
Okay, so does anyone know what Scout Spirit is? Anybody have any ideas? Brett?
It's like happy and being careful with nature and stuff like that.
Okay. Does anybody else have anything? An idea? Zach?
Being cheerful throughout work and anything else your senior patrol leader or adult committee might have you do.
Whoa. Yeah, that actually sounds like a good idea. Does anybody else have anything?
Are you sure that wasn't word for word on paper?
No, it's not. Mr. Cholsky.
Remaining positive and or cheerful on campouts, when sometimes you forget something, you still do your best to just have a great time.
Yeah, that's actually pretty spot on, I think. Actually, I have the definition right here. So according to BSA, Scout Spirit is an ideal attitude that scouts around the world are supposed to show based on adherence to the Scout Oath and Law, which is like just following it in every your everyday life. So what you do matters, like Scout Spirit. Okay, now I'm gonna do a story. I think some of you probably know it.
Story time.
But
maybe boy?
Some of you don't. There's a legend, a tale of sorts. This legend would come shortly after the time of Jack the Ripper. In fact, this story would also take place in London. through the dark streets where Jack the Ripper himself plagued the city. One poor unfortunate soul, W.D. Boyce, an American newspaper man, would find himself in a potentially perilous predicament as he attempted to find a safe haven from the elements of the night. With a fog whisking around him as if to ensnare him, Boyce found himself hopelessly lost. When out of the darkness, what would appear? Yes, it was the unknown scout, a boy. This brave young lad stepped out, came to Boyce's aid, and guided Boyce safely to his destination. Sorry to let you down, there's no guts or gore here. My story, like the many that have preceded this event, has been slightly embellished to portray this night as a significant event. However, this night would be just like any other night for this unknown scout. This scout, a member of the Boy Scout Association of Britain, was just behaving in a manner that one would expect from a Boy Scout. As Boyce insisted on tipping the lad for his time and efforts, the unknown scout refused, explaining that he was merely doing his duty, and went about his way. Boyce was so overwhelmed with this young man's dedication to help others that he took time out of his busy schedule, which he was going to a safari, so it was pretty busy, and stopped by the Boy Scout Association so then he could gather information about it. W.D. Boyce completed his safari and headed back to Chicago, where he lived, to start the work for what would become America's largest youth organizations. During this time, there were several organizations for boys, but Boyce's Boy Scouts of America would leave them all in the dust. When Boyce established the Boy Scouts of America on February 8, 1910, he would leave all rival boys' organizations behind him. The Boy Scouts of America was started in 1910 because of an act of kindness and one boy who was merely performing his good turn for the day. The unknown scout never imagined that his actions would have been the inspiration and startup for such a movement. It just goes to show that we all can make a difference in this life, whether we realize it or not. So that's it. So, did anyone hear anything like special that stood out to them during that story? Anybody?
Jack the Ripper didn't kill them.
No, he didn't. JD?
He didn't accept any, like, rewards or actions. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so he was just doing his good turn. Does anybody else have anything that stood out to them? Mr. Stouffer.
How one small deed can do a great thing, like one drop of water in a pond can make the whole pond ripple.
Yeah, that's actually a really good analogy.
Thank you. Checks in the mail.
So now,
what you started, Noah started off and he said, what you do matters. And, you know, to me, I think about that, you know, the whole oath and law, it was a small act of kindness, you know, that inspired such a change in the lives of so many people. And you guys, you know, we all have that opportunity every day to do goodwill gestures, to lift people up rather than to tear them down, or to help people rather than just to turn the other way. People notice that. They do. It might not stick out in your mind, or you might not get all these great praises or think that you're making a difference, but you really do. Sometimes it takes a week later or a couple months later. But I like this story because it's just one simple small act
that made such a big difference. I mean, we're all here together tonight and, professing to live by this better way because of a boy who was probably your guys' age, 12 or 14 years old. And that night, the decision that he made to help somebody out made a huge difference around the world. So I want you guys to realize how much power you really have and how much strength there is in doing good things, living out your oath and your law. That story always blows me away. Because I can forget as much as anybody how much of an impact I can make.
Okay, so to close, we're going to do a little bit of a game, I guess. So we're going to all get in a big circle. We're going to all